This is a pretty involved lesson, and I don't expect you to absorb it all at once, but I do want you to at least heard the idea. I know it's taken me about 20 years to really grasp this whole concept. Let's get started. In previous lessons, we've seen that the order of transforms for an object is usually rotate and then translate. For example, we start with the letter F at the origin. If we rotate it negative 45 degrees, we get a tilted F. We then translate it by 1 unit vertically, and it moves up. This we write out as TR, with the matrices applied in reverse order. However, we're now able to use matrices whichever way we want. So say we reverse the order. If instead we first translate up a unit, then rotate, we get this, the notation RT. Clearly different, with T changing the origin we then rotate around. Here's another way to look at it. Say we first just rotate the F. We express this by the notation R. We could add a translation matrix before or after this rotation. If we add it before the R, this means we translate the object after the rotation, and so move it with respect to the world. Whatever happened before this translation was applied is said and done. The object is in whatever orientation that's already been set. Ancient history. So TR is this top case, as before. If we put the T after the R, it says to apply the translation first, then everything is rotated around the origin. So far, I haven't said anything new. However, another way to look at all this is that you're changing the frame of reference by each of these transforms. Instead of rotating or translating the object, we can think about it as changing this frame of reference. By taking this new path, we can think of the transforms in these terms. First, the rotation changes the frame of reference that any transforms to the right of it will use. Then the translation moves the object with respect to this new frame of reference. Any point in space is given some xyz coordinate only with respect to something. We started off by thinking of this something as world space, but notice that we've actually been making models in what we call model space and then transforming them to world space. For example, when we have a parent-child relationship, the child is oriented with respect to the parent, not the world. So it's all about respect, just a little bit. When we put the T matrix after the R, we're saying to translate with respect to the view of the world of the R matrix. So putting the T here moves objects with respect to the R matrices' frame of reference. That is, the translation is done with respect to the R's y-axis. Putting the T in front of the R means that the translation is not done in the R's frame of reference, but in the world's frame of reference. The R itself is now influenced by the T's frame of reference. Another way to say this is that the first matrix to the right of some given set of matrices is transforming the object with respect to that set. In other words, everything to the left of it. For example, on the top here, the rotation is transforming the F with respect to the frame of reference of the T translation to its left. This all may sound obtuse, but think of someone looking at a hubcap in your model. He wants to know where it's located and what angle it's at. You might describe it as, well, I moved the hubcap so it would be properly attached to the wheel, and then I moved the wheel so that, but he cuts you off. I don't care how it got there, where is it now? When you positioned the hubcap, you weren't really moving the hubcap to its position, you were positioning it with respect to the wheel's frame of reference, and then you were positioning the wheel with respect to the car's frame of reference. It's more like the car's location and the wheel's location were maps for where the hubcap should go. Different frames of reference are just like you might use latitude and longitude to fly somewhere, then use a street map, a different frame of reference, to get to the airport to the office, then use a map of the building to find the room you want. Each frame of reference takes you to the next.